Loxians will taking the orange team. Evade attack at first. Hopefully the settings are right. I checked them 5 times. And the bands are starting. Perfect. My team's scrimming right now. I'm the coach for Dark Angel, so I'm kind of doing 2 things at once, making sure they got in the scrim. Thatcher ban. Start out this game. Aw, thank you, Average. I like casted too. Thatcher and Monty are your attacking bans. Evade going with the Monty ban. And the first defensive ban going out is the Echo. Evade, week 1, they lost to OG World on Clubhouse. Robloxians lost last week on Villa. Alright, the Valkyrie coming out. Gone on Consulate. Pretty common band with all those palm trees out there. My memory is correct. Evade all likes to ban the Monty and the Echo. Alright, first sight's gonna be a console hold. Ready to get started. Ooh, Amaru. Gonna be peeking in on her a lot. See what she's gonna have up her sleeve. That is a mistake, likely for Divine Ace. Let's see if he 6 picks off of the that glass. Yep. Right on cue. And the Warden will be changed with the... Oh, it was a Malusi. Had us for a second, but Flippy Face is going to settle on the Mute. Glass switches to the IQ, and IQ has Diffuser. And here we go. Attackers round 1, evade. And defuse bombs. Against Robloxians. Robloxians will be defending first here. I'm gonna be, simplicity purposes, I'm just gonna be spectating mostly the offensive team for first person views and just going over at the defense. Just to keep it simple. Divine Rogue has her, has a Maru's drone in there. Flippy Face following. This is what the setup's gonna look like here. Robloxians 1-1, Evade 1-1. Evade is yet to win a game without a forfeit. Nitro Tactics forfeited, giving Evade the win.
5 seconds insertion.
And here's Robloxians trying to rebound off their loss last week on Villa to the hands of Fedless, the first place team in the Alpha Division. So let's get started now. Gonna be keeping an eye on that Amaru. She's gonna mow right into Admin. And just like that, Admin control. Amaru is rushing. McQueen Speed will pick up the first kill on the Nomad. Divine Rogue rushing in, picking up the kill on Flippy Face. Finds the Legion. The Legion will deny that rush. Quickly a 4v3 with 2.5 minutes to go. And now the round settles down. IQ going by herself inside of Visa. No one's around her, though. Pretty safe so far. Meanwhile, the Twitch and the Thermite late to the party, but they'll be spawning by Garage. And Midnight Ace will actually pick up the kill. Nice angle on a yellow. Jaeger is down. You got Beto and Legion peeking through Visa. IQ in a gunfight now. IQ's actually outside. Meeting up with the Thermite. Interesting take here. As Midnight Ace once again picks up another kill on that Twitch. She's on that console window. Trying to fight that Smoke who's holding the pixeling. It's an ACOG versus Smoke's probably Hollow Sight. I go back to the aerial view now. Smoke still on the yellow stairs as Dindin the Potato on that Smoke will finally pick up the kill on that Twitch. 2v2 now. Beto sitting inside of Admin. Smoke on those yellow stairs. Let's see what Thermite's going to do now. Great, waiting to go up that yellow. Smoke still on those yellow stairs. Castle now rotating back into meeting. Thermite's gonna go up. Looks like to be a spiral stairs take.
Attackers have dropped the bomb.
And IQ gets immediately shot down. Nice angle right there by Dignit the Potato. Thermite's the last one left in a 1v2. 1 minute left. Thermite. Smoke goes down. Still a 1v2. Behind the desk is the castle. Now Thermite's gonna head on over to yellow. Back to spiral stairs. And waiting for that Thermite is Beto. Look at Beto right now. And Smoke. Legion trapped immediately, and down goes the Thermite. It was a very uncoordinated take to start out for Evade. And it ends uncoordinated as well. Thermite down. Beto picks up the kill. A 2K for Dindin, including that nice kill for Smoke on the IQ. On the skylight, McQueen picks up the early frag. Fluffy and Beto also pick up a kill of their own. Midnight Ace picks up a kill from console window. Now it's going to be a cafeteria garage take. Bandit Jaeger Doc coming out along with the Legion. Oryx, who's allowed to be played now. First week of Oryx and Ayana availability along with proximity mines. Blitz, Sophia, Twitch, Thermite, Nomad. Let's see if it'll be more coordinated. For Evade, it was a little lackluster in round one.
Defenders, protect your bombs from being defused by attackers. Attackers have located a bomb.
Alright, for those of you who just joined right now, orange team is Robloxians, the blue team. Evade. Both teams 1-1 in the Alpha Division. Both teams playing in their third game of the 8-week Infamous League season. Oryx taking a little bit to get started here. Actually, AFK for that first round.
5 seconds to insertion.
Jaeger will be inside of Visa.
Attackers are heading out to defuse
the
bomb.
Get this second round started. Looks like it's going to be a garage spawn point for basically everyone here. No spawn peaks coming out on those yellow stairs. It'll be an easy take for that Blitz. Interesting to see what kind of vertical play they'll have here with that Sophia. Let's see if anyone is actually holding piano. Doc is on the base of yellow stairs. Looks like an archives hold for that Legion. Bandit obviously ready to Bandit Trick. Bandit Trick coming out here in the Nomad. Is going to throw that Nomad in. The wall actually gets down. 40 seconds in. Wall already broken without vertical play needed. Dindin the Potato falls back behind that white van as Fluffy Duck will pick up the kill and Divine Rogue. Sophia down immediately. Got Legion on pipes. Doc on yellow stairs. Blitz swinging all the way around. Back to garage as Dindin the Potato. Another kill. Midnight Ace down. To the hands of, I believe, Fluffy Duck on that Jaeger. Oh, actually, Bandit didn't hit the potato. Now Thermite trying to hold long angles. Another stagnant push here for Evade. Smoke goes out. Blitz goes in immediately. He's Legion trapped. He's getting hit for 25 health as Divine Cloak will pick up the kill on Fluffy Duck. McQueen Speed will refrag. Down goes the Twitch. Now it's just Blitz and Smoke. With no smokes left, Bandit running out and picking up the kill. Actually, a team kill. Spells the end for Divine Ace. And another stagnant push here for Evade. Down goes a Thermite, down go the hands of a team kill. And it's quickly 2-0 Robloxians. Once again, stagnant push. They took no map control and just tried to push the garage and nothing was happening there. They did pick up a couple kills. As now it's going to be a lobby press room take. Pulse, Mozzie, Jaeger, Warden, and Oryx. Probably one of those ops are getting 6th pick. Yep, the Warden. And the Gridlock will be 6th picking. Lion for Evade. Warden would be moving on to a Maestro. This is actually one of Maestro's best maps here on Consulate with the angles you can get from Garage. But they're going to use a Maestro for Lobby and Press Room here. Let's go down to the first floor. See their setup. So far, 15 people watching. That's a new record for me.
Defenders, protect your bombs from being defused by attackers. Attackers have discovered the location.
Scaling a hatch to start this round. Reinforcements coming up. Looks like it's going to be a meeting hold with the hatch open. No smoke. Fluffy Duck a little late to the party to get started. Beta reinforcing. See who's holding. It's going to be interesting to see how long Dindin the Potato can hold meeting. Bait does not control any kind of map. They do not get any type of map control those first two rounds. So that Mozzie is going to have a fun time up there inside a meeting. Interesting to see if they're going to push them out. Looks like Ash might go upstairs to console. Sophia looking for spawn peaks. IQ following the Ash. Thermite on main lobby. Lion outside of piano. Thermite still trying to long angle it. That long desk. No one's back there. Below the floor is actually Beto and Jaeger. Meanwhile, second floor, it's a... looks like it's an Oryx Mozzie hold with Maestro inside a bathroom. As Fluffy Duck will pick up the kill immediately onto the IQ. Still trying to long angle it. Is that Sophia? No kills coming there. Ash on her drone. Thermite trying to push garage now. Diffuser is down with the IQ. Let's see what kind of McQueen speed. Still right there on that garage door as Thermite falls off. Fluffy Duck will pick up the kill on Divine Cloak. Down goes a line with no lions used. Oryx and Jaeger. Jaeger will run out. Down goes a Thermite. Still no map control. Ash alone on the roof. Sophia still holding that angle for a minute. 5v2. The round is in the hands of Robloxians. This whole game has been in the hands of Robloxians so far. It's just going to be a 5v2. Much easier to spectate. Ash trying to push garage. Sophia still trying to hold that main lobby, hoping for a kill. 90 seconds left. Someone's to the right of that door. It's an Oryx. And will Sophia find that Oryx? Oryx still... Yep, down goes the Oryx. Divine Rogue will pick up that kill. Still a 4v2 with a minute 10 left. Still no map control of any kind for Evade. As going down the runouts, the Jaeger, Midnight Ace will pick up the kill. Another runout for the Maestro. Sophia potatoing and getting down immediately. Defender Maestro's still out there, and he will actually make it out alive. Ash totally whiffing on that kill. 1v3 with 50 seconds to go. Evade, I guess they were waiting for the aggressive play. They got it. They didn't get any advantage from it. Interesting to see Maestro outside of the door, ready to run out. Goes the impact just to spook the Ash, and the Ash downs Midnight. Midnight Ace downs Dindin the Potato. So it's just a Maestro and a Pulse with 30 seconds left. Ash does have Diffuser. She'll be going up what looks like to be Spiral Stairs.
Defender has been discovered.
Maestro runs out. He's going back to main lobby, and the Pulse will pick up that kill on the Ash below. So it was a confusing round throughout. Evade got no map control. Scenes just took advantage. Got a little aggressive there. I wouldn't say almost through, but... it was closer than Robloxians would have wanted it. As we go to round 4, console meeting once again. For Robloxians. Blackbeard, Buck, Sled, Sophia, and Thermite coming out. Thermite's been used every single round. Lucy's obviously going to have to get 6-picked. Buck is going to 6-pick as well, realizing that probably vertical play won't be needed as much. IQ to look for the Jaegers, but that's about it. That's all IQ can see with this lineup. Interesting pick there to go off that Buck.
Attackers need to locate
so,
and defuse
back to console we go.
3-0
Robloxians. Queen Speed really... breaking in Oryx of the Infamous League. This is the first week where Oryx and Ayana are allowed. Proximity mines are also allowed too. And of course the new ops, Ace and Malusi. The meta changers are obviously not allowed quite yet. Maybe next season.
10 seconds to insertion.
Castle's going out for Pato here. Queen speed running around. Looking for something. Nice vault there. Din in the potato, attackers holding the common angle inside of yellow, and Fluffy Duck giving him some ADSs. So, let's see what Evade can do now. Map control. Same as say it again, that's what they need. They haven't gotten it for any of those three rounds.
Swapping mags.
Sophia crawling her way to victory. That will bring it back from a 3-0 deficit.
Swapping mags.
You got Thermite already making his way all the way around. Divine Rogue as well. Looks like Fluffy Duck is on spiral stairs going down. Din-Din the potato as I rotate from bathroom to yellow. Queen speed is in meeting. Drones coming out here for the Sophia, Thermite, and the Sledge, and they'll break right into garage. So it's a two-man push. Blackbeard and IQ going in from Visa, three-man push inside of garage, but no one is down there. So it's bottom floor control here, as Beta will pick up the kill on the Blackbeard. No window play for Blackbeard. He was just going straight into VIP. IQ immediately gets away, and she is by herself as Divine Rogue will refrag on the Fluffy Duck on the Jaeger inside of Visa. Nade coming out from the Sledge. Thermite and Sophia still walking aimlessly around. The main lobby is McQueen speed on the Oryx will take care of Divine Rogue. Down goes the Sledge. IQ on her drone. Sophia watching below, and Thermite just sauntering around with nowhere to go. Sophia's in a gunfight. Thermite will now take that gunfight. It looks like it's a castle. Beto below, trying to flank through spiral. Spray's coming, but no one's there. DHE smoke will get the kill on a flippy face, the dock. Interesting place here by the castle. Din-Din the potato. I'm sorry, Beto will pick up the kill. Divine cloak on a McQueen speed. So it's an IQ and a Thermite, the only two people left. Both pushing alone, as that IQ is lit. And smoke will pick up at least 50 health on the IQ. Din-Din the potato is less, but he picks up the kill on the shotgun and will immediately go retreat up to yellow stairs. Last one left is that IQ. It's a castle who will pick the IQ and immediately win round four. Uncoordinated the push. Uncoordinated pushes, the story of these first four rounds for Evade. Simply takes advantage. 4-0 lead already. Evade looking for some sort of luck on the offensive side. Cafeteria and garage. Looks like a Tachanka switches to the Mira. So you got spooked. IQ, Zof, Ying, Ash, and Gridlock. No Thermite this time for Evade, as the Ying will switch on over to the Jackal to find those roamers. And Ella will switch to Warden, thinking that Ying hasn't been six-picked. So a little six-pick trickery coming out there for Evade, forcing the Warden play. Warden won't be needed as much anymore.
Attackers need to locate and defuse as many bombs as they can.
And let's go down to garage. So the second time Robloxians has been a garage, Oryx scales that hatch immediately. 4-0 Robloxians on the orange team. And to be exact, Warden will not be used at all. No flashbangs of any kind. Last time, 40 seconds in, Evade got that wall open. No bandit trick. And Warden takes a little bit of health, actually. Loses 50 health. Divine Rogue has Sophia's drone in there. Common mirror is being set up to watch the garage. That will open immediately.
5 seconds.
Beto doing some work on Visa stairs with his legions. He'll be going up spiral. And round five has officially started. Looks like everyone's spawning parking garage here, trying to get that Visa take. Ping goes out there for the IQ. As Jackal, Ash, and Gridlock will be going into admin. So pretty common take. Gotta take admin. Gotta take piano, gotta take meeting and console. Looks like what's gonna happen here. As far as roamers go, looks like Beto is kind of the only roamer. He's going back to Scythe though. No one's in piano, no one's in bathroom, so IQ and Divine Rogue on the Sophia. As Fluffy Duck will immediately kill McQueen speed with the Nitro Cell. I don't know what happened there. as rappelling in is Zofia and the IQ. So they have console control. They have meeting control. They're going to meet inside of meeting as Legion will pick up the kill going up on Visa Stairs. 4v4 now. Legion will retreat back to site and run for the hills. Jackal looking for any type of footsteps on Yellow, but he can't find anything. Zofia's peeking Spiral. IQ helping the Jackal out on Yellow. And Gridlock will be with Zofia peeking down Spiral. So they have second floor control. Now they gotta get piano control. No one is in piano right now. Beto is actually holding. He's actually running down to archive. So yeah, no one's in piano right now. Jackal sees footsteps, but doesn't scan. Gridlock also in piano. So a three-man piano take, but they can't get the wall open because they don't have a thermite. IQ's lacking behind on second floor. Zofia trying to play vertical play for basically nobody at this point. The Jackal still has his tracker on. Gridlock as well. 108 to go. Beto here coming on the flank as Dint in the Potato picks up the Nitro Cell kill. Legion on the prowl here. Gridlock and Legion are about to have a nice little gunfight right here. 58 seconds to go in a 4v3. Legion looking at Gridlock, can't find the head or even the body. Warden also up there as well. Gridlock will lose 50 health. Zofia doing work inside bathroom. IQ watching cafeteria as Zofia in a gunfight here. But it looks to be Warden. Warden's now at 50 health. Will re-peek and still stay on Yellow as Legion will pick up the kill on a Gridlock. IQ the refrag. It's now a 3v1 as Fluffy Duck picks up the kill on Divine Rogue. 3v1 for almost full health IQ. Bandit, Warden, Mira. Warden has his glasses on in a 3v1. IQ's gonna meet the Bandit, kill the Bandit. He has to hurry. IQ running for his life and he'll get shot down. Warden saying you can't run forever. Find the kill on the IQ, and it's now a 5-0 lead for Robloxians. Evade can't get anything going. As I'm losing viewers. Because it's 5-0, probably. And I don't blame them. Last defensive round coming out for Robloxians. 5-0 lead. A little bit better this time for Evade. They took control of top floor, second floor. They took control of piano, but they didn't have a thermite to capitalize on it. Blitz. This will be the second time Evade will take a blitz if they take them. They don't. They take the buck. No thermite needed, as they know they're probably going to go lobby and press. Last time, it was runouts for Robloxians that spelled the end for Evade. Last time they went to lobby and press.
Defenders, protect your bombs from being
defused. It was a 5v1, I believe, almost immediately, too. Oryx.
Attackers have located a bomb.
Getting broken in quite well. I believe an Oryx has been played at least every round, maybe if not 4 out of the 5 rounds are from the Bloxians.
Bomb located by attackers.
Last time they had that Maestro, who's not getting played now, but last time they had a Maestro in bathroom. 2 people in garage and 2 people upstairs. So far, Mozzie's the only person upstairs.
I'm reloading.
Oryx and Jaeger.
10 seconds to go.
Following each other.
Five seconds to go.
Oryx will scale the hatch again.
Attacker's objective is to defuse a bomb.
Alright, let's see. Any spawn peaks coming out? You're up 5-0, why not? Repelling up to admin is Buck and Ash so far. Nobody is in admin as far as the second floor take. A whole party up there. Mozzie, Jaeger, and the Oryx. 3 people inside as Ella picks up an early gunfight. A Fluffy Duck takes some health loss. We'll open it up. Go for the run out. We'll immediately kill Divine Cloak. Nice call out there. Ying down immediately.
Defenders left the area of operation.
Thanks to the run out. Rattled is Zofia and IQ who are down below. No one's on Yellow Stairs so far. Mozzie and Ella's Fluffy Duck will get a team kill here. Interesting play here. We don't need the Mozzie anyway, say Fluffy Duck. 4v4 with 2 minutes left. Bloxians wants a challenge. Lippy Face still upstairs. McQueen on the meeting hatch. Beto on cams. Ash is inside of admin now, along with Buck. So let's see what kind of gunfights can happen from here. IQ and Zofia still down below. IQ picks up the kill, a double kill on the orcs and the bandit. Meanwhile, let's look at the admin take. Buck is now inside a meeting, finds the Jaeger, but will not get the kill. I don't know what the Jaeger was doing there. Lippy Face, 3v2. Ella and the Jaeger versus the IQ and Zofia down below. Ash is still inside of admin. She did not push with the Buck, and that proved costly there as Jaeger was not refragged. The Face is still up. Jaeger is still upstairs. As holding that angle inside a meeting. Ella down in lobby where she got the run out peak last time. Ash has no idea what's going on inside of admin right now. Trying to peek. Hopefully that Jaeger will peek, but he's holding a nice little pixel. Another look at the Jaeger. Nice pixel inside a meeting. IQ trying to clear out Visa head level. Now we'll go up to Visa. Will she run right into Jaeger's trap? IQ will clear out what Ash has already cleared. A little redundant clearing here as Fluffy Duck will make it 2v2. Zofia down. Let's see what's going to happen with that Jaeger. IQ holding the long angle long desk. They're with the diffuser. 30 seconds to go. No sight control. Ash is going to peek meeting. Aggressive peek. And Ash is in a gunfight here. What's going on behind the table? Jaeger will pick him up with the pistol. IQ's going for the refrag, finds the Jaeger, and will bring him down. 1v1, 10 seconds to go. IQ has to drop hatch and immediately plant. And IQ forgets the diffuser, and she drops down immediately. It's going to be a loss for Evade. A costly cost of them round 6. A mistake that is inexcusable. Forgetting the diffuser. I think they even thought the bomb site might have been inside a meeting. That's why she dropped it. But either way, it's 6-0 Robloxians. Just a disaster for Evade on the attack. Chances of coming back, little to none. Viewers dwindling. 6-0. As now we got some ranked ops. As Caveiro is now picked off. Ash, Sledge, Amaru, Jackal, and a Kali. Jaeger 6 picks to the Jaeger. As Nomad will be taken instead of that Kali. Never mind. It's Kali. Why not get some snipes in? Jaeger, Legion, Capcan.
Defenders, protect your bombs from being defused by attackers.
Alibi and the Bandit. Forgot those ops right there. But here we go. 6-0. Robloxians will get the win.
Bomb located.
All I need is one more sight and 5 more kills at least. Let's see where Capcan places his Capcan traps. He's got 3 left. Common plays here with the Bandit. Legion, Jaeger, Capcan, Alibi. There's the second Capcan.
5 seconds remaining. Attackers are moving to defuse a bomb.
And here we go. And he tricks up Robloxian sleeves. They're up 6-0. You might want to have a little fun here as Amaru rushes right into Piano, and they immediately have Piano control. No hard breacher here for Robloxians. Flippy Face and Kali will immediately be in archives. Let's look at the sniper time. Kali, a nice little hole here. Looking for that Legion. Misses the shot. Actually hits the shot and downs the Legion. Down goes the Legion. Capcan's ready to pick him up. But will he get picked up? It's a bottleneck right now. It's a rush coming for Robloxians. As McQueen Speed team kills. And now Beto's rushing into sight. Beto is in cafeteria. Finds the head of Alibi. As Din in the potato will pick up the kill. McQueen Speed on the sniper rifle. Kill as well. Midnight Divine down. Down on yellow stairs is the Sledge. Capcan is about to die to the hands of Ash right here. And Ash will get the wall bang. 4v1 immediately. Poor Divine Rogue pushing yellow. And one man immediately killed. Just like that. A round that takes 2 minutes and 10 seconds. It is a flawless sweep. 7-0 win for Robloxians. And that definitely helps her around plus-minus advantage. Robloxians are now 2-1. Evade, a disaster, picking up no rounds.